What's up, everyone? We have episode 2 here of the Nutrition for Athletes. We're sitting down with Wes. It's a continuation of the beginning video. Just wanted to split it up, make it so all the information was a little bit more consumable. Today, we're going to be going over animal-based protein compared to plant-based protein and some of the bioavailability that goes with that. So enjoy the video. Like and subscribe if you want to know more about overall athletics nutrition and everything that follows.
What's like the big difference between more of that animal protein in comparison to the plant protein for anybody that's vegan?
So with, besides the amino acid profile, and even with, you know, within the animal-based proteins, you're gonna see that they all vary. They all have different kind of shining moments, as you would say. But between animal and plant, the big one that stands out is what we call bioavailability. Bioavailability is not just going to be found in protein or any type of food. You actually, if you take medicine, let's say you're taking Tylenol, there's actually a certain amount of bioavailability that's in Tylenol. It might be 50%, 60%, what have you. That's where the quality truly comes from.
And real quick, the bioavailability, yep. what he's alluding to is, with the percentages, is basically how well can your body actually absorb whatever it is you're putting in. So we're talking about Tylenol, 50%. 50% of that is actually absorbed by your body. 50% is just put into waste. And we talk about that with protein just because, and really with anything that you put into your body, but protein, there's so many different types of ways you can get protein, and there's different protein powders, and you know, it's all about how well you can package it and label it. So obviously somebody sees a label and says, oh wow, 60 grams of protein, I'm gonna get so many grams of protein each serving for this, and then you find out the bioavailability is only 30%.
Yes.
Now most of it, basically, that means you're just secreting it out and
exactly.
Not actually absorbing the protein. So that's the bioavailability.
Very well said. And the big difference between the plant-based and the animal-based is that plant-based tends to be a lot lower in that bioavailability. So you're going to have to actually eat more protein from plant-based foods than you would from animal-based foods. Also, bioavailability, a lot of times when we talk about supplements, we're talking about the whey protein, right? That's a huge one. You're probably going to find it, unless it's a vegan supplement, you're probably going to find a whey protein. The reason being is because whey protein isolate has one of, if not the highest, bioavailability. I think it's about 96% that they've gotten it up to. I think hydrolyzed whey might even be at 99% now.
Wow.
So if you're taking about 20 grams of whey protein, compared to 20 grams of pea protein, you're absorbing about 19 grams of that 20 with the whey protein. Pea protein, it could be even as low as 12 out of 20, just because the DNA difference between human DNA and a pea plant is very, very different. Whereas dairy, the DNA in dairy is actually very similar to our DNA. That's actually where it comes from. And kind of segueing into another big thing is a complete protein versus an incomplete protein. And that's gonna be very crucial for a lot of athletes if they go plant-based, is you're gonna notice that if you go to a vegan supplement, it doesn't just have pea protein. It's gonna have pea protein, it's gonna have rice protein together, because together they make a complete protein, but by themselves they do not. They're incomplete.
Interesting.
Basically what that means, a complete protein has all of the essential amino acids that we need as human beings. There are 9 amino acids that we do not produce enough of to survive. So we have to get it from outside sources. Meat being one of those complete proteins, and the best of which would be an egg protein, actually has the best ratios of all the essential amino acids, which obviously play into muscle growth, 100%.
Yeah, that's great.